So good afternoon everyone. Today's topic is Hamming code. So Hamming codes is 1-bit error correcting code denoted as H of N comma M, where M is number of message bits, N is Hamming code bits, number of Hamming code bits. How we generate Hamming code? Okay. So Hamming code is generated for M bits of message. For m bits of message, k parity bits are available. So then n is equal to m plus k. So how to calculate this k? The condition for k is 2 power k must be greater than or equal to m plus k plus 1. Okay. We have to satisfy these conditions. Okay, if I have k parity bits means p1 to pk, they are located at positions 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, etc. So on 2 power k minus 1. That means powers of 2. That means powers of 2. It is located at powers of 2 means 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, so on. Okay. Let us check how the k values available for different messages. Let us see. Number of parity bits according to the message bits. Here is the table. Suppose I have message bits 2 to 4, the parity bits are 3. Means for 2 bits, we required 3 parity bits. For 3 bits also, we required parity bits 3. For 4 bits also, we have 3. For 5 to 11, we required 4. Means this value is satisfies this equation. Okay. So on for up to 120 values, we have parities. So if you don't know how this formula, just remember, mostly in problems, we get a 4, 8 and 11 bit condition. We get only these values for m. For m is equal to 4, k is equal to 3. For 8 and 11, k is equal to 4. Remember these two values. It's enough. Okay. Next, how to write a Hamming code? First, write the positions based on n. If n is 7, means up to write 1 to 7. Write up to 1 to 7. If n is equal to 12, means write up to 12. If n is equal to 15, means write up to 15. Okay, and suppose I given message bits m is equal to 4. Okay, notate them as m1, m2, m3, and m4. If 8, I given m is equal to 8 bits, then write m1, m2, m3, m4, m5, m6, m7, m8, like this. Okay, and now write down. The values you already know. P's are located at which positions? Powers of 2's position means 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, so on. At the positions only we have P's. So let us check it. See, at first position P1, next second position P2, next M1. Next P3, M2, M3, M4, next P4, M5, M6, M7, M8, M9, M10, M11, and next P5. So mostly we learn about up to M11. In this syllabus, we learn up to here only. Okay, remember these positions. Okay, where P is parity, M is message. Next, calculation of parities. How we calculate parities? So P1 is selected at even parity of positions 1, 3, 5, 7, so on. Odd numbers, all odd number positions. Or our XOR of leave the first bit and all remaining positions. P2 is selected as even parity of 2, 3, 6, 7. Or our P2, XOR of 3, 6, 7. Left first bit. Similarly, P3. Okay, so on. How we calculate these P1, P2, P3? Let us check it. Now we generated Hamming code. Okay. Next is I transmitted it. One error is occurred. For that, we have to correct the error. How to find out the error position? For error position, we calculate like this. After receiving the code word, the error position will be detected as follows. C is equal to C1, C2, C3, so on, CK. We have to calculate this position. Okay. For 7 bits, how many parities are there? Same values are available here, C also. If parity is 3, C1, C2, C3. If parity is 4, C1, C2, C3, C4. Those values are calculated as C1, XOR of 1, 3, 5, 7. Okay, C2, XOR of 2, 3, 6, 7, so on. C3, XOR of 4, 5, 6, 7, so on. Okay, note, important. XOR is equal to 1 means the output is equal to 1. If number of 1s are odd, XOR is equal to 0. If number of ones are even, remember this one condition, XOR condition. Okay, let us do one problem. You can understand about it. Hamming code. First, I given message M1, M2, M3, M4 means it is 4 bit. 4 bit means calculate K. K is equal to this condition, you have to satisfy this one. So K is equal to 3. Okay. Now M is equal to 4, K is equal to 3. So N is equal to how much? 7. So Hamming code is denoted as 7, 4. Now positions are right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now parities. At first position P1, second position P2, at fourth position P3. Okay, next M1, M2, M3, M4. Okay, now calculate P1. P1 is even parity of 1, 3, 5, 7. P2 is even parity of 2, 3, 6, 7. P3 is even parity of 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, or our XOR operation. Next. Checking once for each parity bit and select the position of parity calculation. How we calculating the parity position? You know, see in previous step, you write P1 is 1, 3, 5, 7. How you know this one? Let us see how. We have 3 parity bits, right? P1, P2, P3. Means 3 bit number. For 3 bit number, write these values. 0 to 7. Okay? Binary numbers. Now P1. Check where the ones are available. Where ones are available. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here ones are available. At which one? 1, 3, 5, 7. Okay, for P2, check where ones are available. 2, 3. Next, 6, 7. For P3, check where when ones are available. 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, 4, 5, 6, 7. Like that, we calculating P1, P2, P3. Similarly, C1, C2, C3 also same. C1 means 1, 3, 5, 7. P2, 2, 3, 6, 7. P3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Same, similar way. See, for 7, 4 Hamming code, same calculate C1, C2, C3 as 1, 3, 5, 7, 2, 3, 6, 7, 4, 5. Same, okay. Now, based on that value, C1, C2, 3, C3, write in reverse order. After calculating C1, C2, C3, write in reverse position. C3, C2, C1. Okay, in binary value. If you get 0, 0, 0 means no error. If you get 0, 1, 1 means error at third position. If you get 110 means error at sixth position, like that. Okay. Let us see one example. After knowing the error position, replace that bit with complement 1. Now let us see one example. Generation of Hamming code. Generate Hamming code for 0100. Okay, here we get this is M1, M2, M3, M4. 4 bit means parity is equal to 3. P1, P2, P3. So now write the positions. First step is we get M value 4, K value 3. Also we get n value, that is 7. N is equal to 7. So write positions now. Given length n is equal to 4, m is equal to 4, parity bits 3. Okay, positions 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now write notations. P1, P2, M1, P3, M2, M3, M4. Now write values. We don't know P1, P2, P3, but we know M1, M2, M3, M4. So write those values. M1, M2, M3, M4. Okay, we write it. Next, we have to calculate P1. P1 is available at 1, 3, 5, 7. So first we don't know P1. This is after writing ISR. We don't know P1. Okay. Just calculate it now. P1 is 1, 3, 5, 7. So 3, 5, 7. 3, 5, 7. We don't know this one, P1. Now write P1. 1, 3, 5, 7. Now even parity is what? 0, 1, 0. Even parity is 1. So P1 is equal to 1. Okay. Next, P2. P2 is available at 2, 3, 6, 7. 2 is P2. Don't consider that one. Next, 3, 6, 7. Okay. 3 value is 0. Right? 6 value is 0. Next, 7 value is 0. 0, 0, 0. So even parity is 0. So P2 is 0. This one is P2. So I am writing now after calculating. Okay. Next. Calculate P3. P3 is 4567. 4567. So 4 is P3. We have to calculate this one now using remaining 3. 100 is even parity. We have 1. So P3 is 1. So what is the position? 101. So replace P1, P2, P3 with 101. Okay. Then you get values. Code word is 100 1100. This is the correct code word. Using this code word, I received now some with error. What is that error? I receiving now this code 100 100. Okay. I changing the fifth bit. Okay, now I changing this fifth bit 1 with 0. So this is the code I receive. Now you have to check the error is occurred at fifth position or not. Okay, let us check it. Now find the error position for received Hamming code. This one is received. You already know it is 5. But let's calculate, you getting 5 or not. So for 7 positions, we have only C1, C2, C3. Let us calculate. Message received. Now, parities. C1, 1357. 1357. So C1 is 1. Okay. Parity check. You can do XOR operation also. XOR operation means 1000. Ones are odd. So C1 is equal to 1. Next, 2367. 2367. C2 is 0. Next, 4567. 1000. C3 is 1. So error code is 101. So position is fifth position, right? We get fifth position. Now replace fifth position bit with complement. What is the value available here? 0. So complement it. Answer is 1. So 100 1100. This is the correct word. Next, similarly, 12,8 Hamming code. So 12,8 means M is equal to 8, right? Sorry, I given here 4, replace with 8. Okay, this is not 4, replace with 8. M is equal to 8. Next parity, K value is equal to 4. So M is equal to 8, K is equal to 4. Therefore, N is equal to 12. Hamming code is 12,8. Positions 1 to 12. For 1 to 12, parities are located at powers of 2. 1, 2, 4, 8. Let us see. So P1, P2, P3, P4, remaining all messages. Okay, P1, P2, M1, P3, M2, M3, M4, P4. Okay. Now, P1 is calculated at 1357911. P2, 2367111. P3, 4567112. P4, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. How? Let us see the table. Okay. See the table. Okay, C is this table now. P1 means, let us check ones where available. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. P2, 2, 3, 6, 7, 10, 11. P3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 12. P4, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, like that, we have to calculate all positions. Okay, error detection is similar process. We have to calculate C1, C2, C3, C4. C1 means XOR off. C2 is XOR operation. C3 same value, we replacing with C1, C2, C3, C4. Okay, based on bit, you find out the position. Next, generate Hamming code for this message. See, I given 8-bit message now. So M is equal to 8, possible K value is 4. So N is equal to 12. Therefore, Hamming code is 12, 8. Positions 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 12. P1, P2, M1, P3. We write now all things. Next, original message. Write down these values. Now calculate P1. So P1 means even parties. So here we have odd number of 1. So total 1 must be even. So P1 is equal to 1. P2. 2, 3, 6, 7. Okay. 2, 3, 6, 7, 10, 11. So 2, 3, 6, 7, 10, 11. So even parity is 1. So P2 is equal to 1. Like that. Similarly, P3. P3 equal to 0. P4 is equal to 0. So now replace the code words. The code message is 111001001. Okay. Now Hamming code 15, 11. Same process. M is equal to 11 bits. So parity is equal to K is equal to 4. So total number of length is 15 bit. So up to 15. P1 to 15. 1 to 15. P1, P2, P4. Okay. The positions are like this. M5, M6, M7, M8, M9, M10, M11. Now calculate P1. How we calculate P1? Let us see the table. So P1 means odd numbers. P1, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15. P2, 2, 3, 6, 7, 10, 11, 14, 15. P3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 12, 13, 14, 15. Next P4, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay. Similarly, C1 also same value. C1, C2, C3, C4. Same values. It receives same values. XOR operation we perform. C1, C2, C3. Okay. By using this table. 0 means if you get C value is 0 means no error. Remaining numbers we get, that position is error position. So replace it with complement value. Example. Now I am receiving the code word. Hamming code. I received this one. So total bits are 15 bits. Let us check it. So total bits are 15. So for 15, how many bits positions we have to calculate? 4. So 15 means we have to calculate C1, C2, C3, C4. Okay. Let us calculate C1. C1 is XOR of 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15. So I writing at 1, what is available? 0, 1, 0. Write all those values. Here total ones are how many? 4. So answer is 0. Next is C2. 2, 3, 6, 7, 10, 11, 14, 15. So total ones, check it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So XOR is 0. Next to C3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay. One second. 9 is not available. So don't write 9. Nine is not available. 4, 5, 6, 7, and 12, 13, 14, 15 only. 9 is not available. Don't write it. So X 0. Next to C4. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So XOR operation is 0. So code word is 40. So there is no error. So next concept is for gate exam, single error correction, double error detection. What we are doing? After generating Hamming code, okay, we add one extra bit. After generating Hamming code, we add one extra bit, which is even parity of that Hamming code. Okay. Now calculate error position. After receiving, calculate error position and also calculate P. Based on these conditions, we have 4 conditions. C is equal to 0, P is equal to 0 means no error. If C not equal to 0 and P is equal to 1, single error occur and that can be corrected. If C not equal to 0 and P is equal to 0, double error occurred. Okay, we cannot correct it. If C is equal to 0 and P is equal to 1, error occurred at newly added position bit. Okay, let us see some examples. You already know this is the code word you generated in 7, 4, right? You already know this is the code word generated for which message? 0100. Okay, this is the code word we get. What is the even parity for this code word? 1. So here P is equal to 1. Okay. Sorry. Okay. This is the newly added bit. Okay. Now calculate C.